Hi everyone, I'm Sherry Bechtel, editor for Finders Investing Channel, and I'm here to tell you all about bonds. Let's dive right in. You may have heard financial planners suggest that you diversify your portfolio with bonds, but what are bonds exactly? A bond is a loan investors make to corporations, governments, and other entities. Every bond has a set term, also known as the maturity date, and these can vary widely but typically range from 1 to 30 years. Throughout this term, you, the investor, receive periodic interest payments from the corporation or government you've lent money to. These payments can be fixed, meaning you know how much interest you're getting each period, or they can be variable, meaning they can change throughout the term based on the fluctuations of the associated rate index, like LIBOR. At the maturity date, the government or corporation agrees to pay back your principal. That's the amount of money you purchase the bond for. It all sounds simple enough, right? But there's a lot more to it than that. Here's what you need to know before you decide to invest in bonds. There are two main types of bonds, government bonds and corporate bonds. Government bonds include U.S. Treasury bonds and municipal bonds. Treasury bonds are issued by the federal government, and interest earned is exempt from state and local income taxes, a huge plus. These are among the safest investments in the world, but that safety means they have very low interest rates, which means you as an investor receive a lower return than you would have investing in riskier securities. Municipal bonds, also known as munis, are issued by states, cities, counties, and local governments. They're usually exempt from federal income tax, as well as state and local taxes if you live in the state where the bond was issued. Corporate bonds are issued by companies. Think of them as IOUs that companies sell to investors that will be repaid at the maturity date. Corporate bonds have higher interest rates than government bonds, but they're also riskier. If the company fails, you might lose some of your investment. As with any investment, bonds have their own benefits and risks. Some benefits to investing in bonds include there's steady fixed income. Since interest payments continue throughout the life of your bond, it's solid passive income. They also provide a higher yield than savings accounts. Some bonds, including municipal and U.S. Treasury bonds, are tax exempt, and they're less risky and often less volatile than stocks. However, they're not without drawbacks. Some of these include a high entry point. Most bonds have a $1,000 minimum investment. You'll also have to pay broker fees. There's a lack of liquidity. You won't be able to access cash before the maturity date, and that could take years. Bonds also have lower returns than stocks and other investments. And there's always that chance that the bond issuer will default on the bond, meaning you could lose some of your investment. There are many ways you can invest in bonds, with some being easier and less expensive than others. First up are bond funds, which invest in a variety of bonds, offering instant diversification. Investing in a bond fund is usually less expensive than buying individual bonds, which typically sell in $1,000 increments. A share of some of the top earning bond funds can go for less than $20, and they pay regular dividends. There are two main types of bond funds, bond ETFs and bond mutual funds, and you can buy both through most online brokerages. Second, you can buy government bonds through the U.S. Treasury Direct website, though it might be cheaper to buy the same government bond through an online broker. And finally, you can invest in new corporate bonds through the primary bond market, though this is the hardest method. You typically need a relationship with the investment bank working with the company to bring its bonds to market. Bonds are typically considered low-risk investments, but they're not bulletproof. Luckily, credit rating agencies exist. These evaluate governments, municipalities, and corporations and rate their bonds. It works kind of like a school paper grading system, with AAA being the highest and D being the lowest. The three main credit rating agencies are Standard & Poor's, Moody's, and Fitch, and they typically group bonds among two different categories. The first is investment-grade bonds, which have a high credit rating of BBB, Baa3, or higher. These ratings suggest that the company is in relatively strong financial position to repay their bonds. The second is high yield or junk bonds, which have a lower credit rating of BB, Ba2, or lower. These ratings suggest that the bond issuer is in tough financial position and may not meet their debt obligations. However, you generally earn higher yields in exchange for the increased risk. Want to learn more about bonds? Be sure to head on over to our complete guide on finder.com. It's linked in the description box below. And if you like this review, don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you'll never miss a new Finder video.